in some problems, you need to show that two sets are the same. But how can you do that? The set shows you have an infinite amount of elements. Think, for example, of the span of some vectors. So you can't compare all elements of both sets. We'll need to do this another way. In this video, you will learn the general methodology so you can apply this idea, this method, to your own problems. So we start with a very small problem just to show how the methodology works. We have three sets, V1, 2, 3, 5, V2, 5, 3, 2, and V3 consisting of the elements 3, 2, 5, and 7. And are they the same or not? Now what we do, we check that every element of V1 is also in V2. So we have in V1, 1 is 2, which is also in V2. We have 3, which is also in V2, and we have 5, which is also in V2. So it means every element of V1 is also in V2, which means that V1 is contained in V2. V1 is a subset of V2. Now, we can also do that the other way around. So we look at the elements of V2, 5, which is also in V1, 3, which is also in V1, and 2, which is also in V1. So every element of V2 is also in V1. So V2 is also contained in V1. So that means V1 is within V2, and V2 is within V1. And if you have those two together, that means that V1 equals V2. Because both V1 is contained in V2, and V2 is contained in V1. And that's the trick. That's how you can show that two sets are the same, by showing those two inclusions. Let's try to show that V1 and V3 are the same with the same reasoning. So V2 is also in V3, 3 is also in V3, and 5 is also in V3. So V1 is contained in V3. Now we look the other way around. Well, let's start directly with the 7. You already see, of course, where it's going wrong. The 7 is not contained in V1, so 7 is in V3, but not in V1. So that means that V3 is not a subset of V1, so that means that V1 and V3 are not the same. So this is a criterion how you can see whether two sets are the same or not. So what do you do? Is V equal to some other set W? So what do you do? First you show that V is contained in W. So how do you do that? You pick any element V in the big V, and you show that this V is also an element of W. That's the first inclusion. And second step, you show that W is a subset of V. How do you do that? You pick any small vector W in your big W, and you show that this W is in V as well. And then you have shown that V and W are the same set. So this is the general idea, how you show that two sets are the same.